Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to share a winter coat guide, or my coat rules that I think everyone should learn. Now, like always when I do these rule type videos, they're not rules that say you have to do these things, but rather they're tips and things that I consider to be non-negotiables when buying my own items because they've really helped me find things that last a long time, look really nice, and are really versatile for my wardrobe. So I'm making really wise purchases and not wasting my money and instead investing in things that I can have and enjoy for many, many years. So let's get started. So my first coat rule is to be really mindful of the material that you're looking for. I think that when looking for a coat that's going to be really versatile, it's going to wear very well over many, many winters and be something that you can dress up a little bit, I think finding something in a beautiful, hopefully 100% wool material is a very good direction to go. In my experience, wool keeps you very, very warm. It's a great insulator, and it's much warmer than cashmere, for example. And cashmere tends to be very expensive, so you're buying a cashmere coat that's insanely expensive, but not really getting the warmth that you get with wool. I also love wool because it's a traditional fabric when it comes to coats, so it's very easy to find wool coats secondhand and vintage. So if you don't want to spend a ton of money, I think it's a really good place to look. And then if maybe you don't want to buy new wool, I think buying vintage and secondhand wool is a beautiful place to spend your money. My next coat rule is to think outside the color box. So when a lot of us think of coats, and especially winter coats, I think we think of dark colors, and that's for very practical reasons. You need something that's not going to show up all the grossness from the winter, and it's not going to show up slush and dirt and all of that. And you also want something that's going to be slightly more formal, so darker colors tend to do that. But I think it's important to consider colors beyond just black. So I recommend looking for something maybe in a navy or a gray. I'm loving gray, and I think it's a beautiful color for a coat. And then of course, camel. My next coat rule is to really consider the fit and make sure that your coat is fitting you in a couple very key places to ensure that you have something that you can wear with all of your chunky layers underneath, but also something that isn't gonna make you feel like you're drowning in your dad's coat. So I think it's very important to make sure that coats fit you in the shoulders and they fit you in the sleeves. I personally really like coats that come past where my sleeve of my shirt would go or my sweater, because I find that it's more practical that way. It looks nicer, it looks more streamlined, and it also keeps me warmer. Just like with blazers, it's also very important that a coat fits you right underneath the arms, so you have a nice snug fit, but it doesn't restrict your movement. So I recommend always wearing a very heavy, thick sweater when coat shopping, if you intend to wear your coat with a heavy thick sweater, and then try it on and make sure that you can move your arms. You should be able to fully bend, rotate, and extend without any weird bunching. I've also found that by making sure those points fit me perfectly, a really inexpensive coat can look more expensive. So similarly, you're really going to want to pay close attention to the length of the coat. So like I mentioned at the beginning, a coat traditionally is something that comes past your hips, I believe. And in my opinion, it's best when it comes to your knee or above your ankle. And finding that sweet spot for yourself is really important to ensuring you have a coat that you really want to wear. So I'm short, I'm 5'3", and finding that good length for me can be kind of tricky at times. So I've got my black coat that comes to my knees, and I really love that for more formal things and when I don't want to feel like I'm wearing just a coat. And I like that because it's very slim. It's a slightly different silhouette than my other coats versus my two camel coats and my new addition to my coat wardrobe, which are slightly bigger and slightly longer. And I find that even though they are long, they hit me at a flattering point on my leg, so it doesn't break it up in any weird ways. My next coat rule is to opt for buttons over zippers. Zippers are so tempting because they're really easy, but in my experience, they also look a little bit more casual. So when you are looking for a coat, and specifically a coat that you can dress up or down, I think you can't go wrong with buttons. And then especially looking for buttons that are really beautiful, they've got some nice decoration or detail on them, and they just complement the coat really well. Also, don't discard a coat just because of the buttons, especially if it's vintage, because you can change out the buttons and kind of customize your coat that way. My next coat rule is to pay very close attention to the collar. I really love a substantial collar on a coat, and specifically something that I can pop up and then button really securely to my neck. it makes a really big difference for me. I get cold very easily, and especially when dealing with proper winter weather, it really just makes a difference in how I feel. I'm able to fill that empty space and maybe unbutton a couple of the buttons if it's not that cold, fill it with a scarf to make it look nice and keep me extra toasty. But then when the weather does get really bad or gets windy, I can pop up the collar and hold it close to my neck for added warmth. So I really recommend looking for a very firm, sturdy collar. I also find that that's a good indicator of the overall quality of the coat. And in my experience, a really low quality, flimsy collar tends to be representative of the overall quality of the coat. And last but not least is to not be afraid to spend a little bit more money on a great coat. Coats are something that you're going to wear a ton during the winter. And if you're anything like me, you'll have a relatively small coat collection. So you need to ensure that they're really high quality and they will last a long time. Hopefully even many, many years, and if not your entire life, if some of us are so lucky. So I think it's so important to be realistic about how much you should spend on a coat. Never, ever, ever go broke for fashion, but don't be afraid to start a coat fund. Save a lot of money and maybe save for a couple years in order to really buy a beautiful coat and something that you can wear and enjoy for many years. Coats are not cheap, but there are ways around it. So you can find coats from retailers that are doing really beautiful work at a lower price point by offering direct to consumer. And then you can also shop secondhand and vintage. You can find amazing coats at very, very low prices. And then of course, shopping off season. By shopping for coats during the summer, for example, or at the end of the winter, you can get great deals and find something really beautiful but heavily discounted. And there you have it. That is my coat guide, or my coat rules, that I think everyone should learn. I hope that you liked this and it gave you some direction. I know personally, when I started my own coat collection a couple years ago, it took me a long time to find all this information. So hopefully this was a good one-stop shop for you, and it kind of sets you on the right path to build a coat collection that you can have and enjoy forever. So like always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Have a great day.